I'm Emily Glover. I'm a senior at Georgia Tech, and I'm a pathways intern at NASA Armstrong. This summer I'm working on heat shield research, specifically measuring the ultraviolet part on the heat shield so that we can make it less heavy for future flights. The internship program at NASA Armstrong focuses on inspiring the next generation. The projects we work on are important, but at the end of the day, it's mostly about making us into the best engineers that we can be.
I'm Jordan Connor. I'm a senior at Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University, and I'm a flight test operations engineering intern here at NASA Armstrong Flight Research Center. I'm working on the unmanned aircraft systems integration into the National Airspace System project. We're trying to integrate small UAS into the human-piloted airspace, and to do this, we're doing flight tests where we fly a manned aircraft towards this one and make sure that the detect and avoid sensors are working so that there's no mid-air collisions. What I do during these flight tests, I'm in the control room, monitoring everything, making sure the autopilot's working correctly, the altitudes are correct, the flight plans are as we inputted them. The advice I'd give to someone wanting to intern here at NASA would be to get good grades, work hard in school. It's really important. However, the most important thing is passion, drive, and people skills, because you'll be using that a lot. And it doesn't matter what your grades are. When you get into the workplace, it's about your people skills and how you can work in a team.
My name is Sarah Estep, and I am going to be a senior at Morehead State University, and I'm majoring in Space Systems Engineering, and I am an intern here at NASA's Armstrong Flight Research Center. So I am an intern on the Mars Glider Swarm / Prandtl-M projects, and our goal is to be able to release a swarm of gliders in the Martian atmosphere to do atmospheric sensing. So to be able to test that this summer, we want to be able to release multiple gliders from a weather balloon. And so specifically, I'm making the release system that's going to hold the gliders and release them here. So I've got to help a lot with laying up the actual molds and fabricating my gondola. So I was able to help pour the epoxy and spread it out, help wrap the carbon fiber around the mold. I got to do some sanding, some soldering. They've really let me help with every step of the process and really helped walk me through it. So I've learned a lot about what goes into actually making something here.
My name is Lauren Newton. I'm going to be a first-year master's student at Stanford University studying aeronautics and astronautics, and I am a Pathways co-op intern in the operations engineering branch here at NASA Armstrong. I'm working on the life support system for the X-59 low-boom flight demonstrator. Essentially, the X-59 seeks to demonstrate quiet supersonic flight without those loud sonic booms that have made overland supersonic flight infeasible in the past. The life support system revolves around making sure that we can get oxygen to sustain the pilot at the inhospitable altitudes we'll be flying at, up to 60,000 feet, both in the aircraft and, God forbid, if the pilot should have to eject and descend to the ground. My responsibilities include getting the system designed and tested, and this includes both the mechanical design of several components in the system, as well as the logistics of getting ready to send it over to Texas for pressure chamber qualification testing. My future plans for the short term are to do a good job in whatever role I may be assigned to next. I aim to complete my graduate studies at Stanford, and then continue to work in flight test engineering. It's something I've wanted to work in ever since I was a kid. Experimental flight in both air and space has always captured my imagination, and I would love to continue that work with NASA.